So we have finished with duotone color, right? We spent a lot of time thinking about the difference between duotone hard edge and duotone soft edge. And let's see how you can even kind of work with both within the same layers once you understand it. So I can lasso and then use tools like dodge and burn. And I can do this for soft effect, or I can do this for hard-edged effect, right? Just to get a little variation. Be a little highlight back there, be a little on the toes. And it goes on and on because we set it up correctly in this kind of sandwich, right? Now, what if we want even more? So I'm going to save it. This is the most that most reproduced images, illustrations go through. But if you really want to make it special, you can shift from duotone to what's called full spectrum color. Full spectrum color is more painterly, though it's still not digital painting because it's still going behind real or implied line art. But it allows you to use any color everywhere, right? So Henri Matisse, the Fauvist, you know, French expressionist, early 20th century, is famous for using unusual colors. This is the same kind of experimentation of people like Gauguin and Van Gogh, right? So you can have greens and blues and purples and yellows and oranges all in your skin tones, right? And when we look at our project, we don't have that. We have tones of lights and darks within each local color. So when can this be effective? If we take this character, which was by a student, right? And you see the duotone soft edge here, very well done. To add full spectrum would be to have kind of tones that mix into every color. So now there's like purples and pinks in the orange, in the skin tone, in the blues, kind of over everything. To continue the Wonder Woman theme, which is a great example of coloring because you always have the primaries, here you have full spectrum in very subtle ways. So you can see yellow and pink and green even in her skin tones. You can see on her gauntlet, not just grays, but purples, pinks, yellows, browns. Here you see the yellow, the purple, the pink in her skin tones. You know, it's all radiating out. You see yellow and pink as well as this kind of purplish gray in her cloak. In her hair, you see pink, you see purple, you see gray. Full spectrum. Here, you see duotone soft edge on the character, very clean, but on the monster she's fighting, the Hydra, for any of you who have a Hydra, it's a really nice example. It's all done with full spectrum kind of soft edge coloring. So it looks more like watercolor. But notice when you use full spectrum, you tend to have to weaken your line art because full spectrum behind heavy line art looks overdone. That was a big problem in digital coloring in the late 90s. So when artists use full spectrum, they have a very light touch with it when it's done with line art. So this is very subtle, but effective. You see all the different colors used within. Behind line art. Just beautiful examples, very subtle within pretty delicate line art. The more ambitious you get with a color, the less you can use your line art, basically. So the thinner the line art gets, or the weaker it gets, until eventually it just becomes digital painting, where the line art isn't even what you're painting with. So let me show you full spectrum. An easy way to do it. We've already done a combined layer, right? We're going to duplicate, again, that combined layer, lock it. And now I'm going to double click it and make a layer style of it. And on that layer style, I'm going to do a gradient overlay over all of it. And instead of it being just a regular black to white gradient, I'm going to choose crazy colors. And whenever you see a gradient, remember, you can click on the gradient and you can customize it. You can make your own colors. In this case, these are going to be the warms and cools that I mix in. It will even have some of the last colors I selected. The warms and cools, I'm going to make them pretty bright, I think. You can add more colors that I'm going to mix in with the duotone coloring and soft-edged and hard-edged coloring I've already chosen. You can see it starting to work, right? Maybe let's throw a purple in there for good measure. I don't use enough purple in my work. And maybe I'll even throw that purple in over here. So this is just experimental playing. Okay, I say okay. It's at 100% on normal mode, but let me use that to set the angle that kind of works well with my composition. Maybe something like that. And then I can try reversing it. Yeah, that kind of works. Yeah, I like that. And then I can play with the scale. Like how wide or narrow is this spectrum? And then I'm going to fix it again. I need something in the middle. Let's do something like that. Okay. So, totally different coloring. At 100%, normal. Okay. But now with this layer, I can play with how opaque it is or how subtle it is. This is called glazing in painting. We're just going to let it subtly affect my colors so that now they still look like the same colors, but now they've got purple in them, green in them, pink in them, all the different tones. That's full spectrum coloring. Maybe you think it works. Maybe you don't. Another way to play with it is to play with your layer style. So I played with opacity, but I can also try, or not layer style, I'm sorry, blending mode. But I can try a different blending mode as well. I could try overlay, which should be a little bit more dramatic. Or I can try darken. You know, they'll be more selective. Some of my favorites are soft light and pin light. So Photopea is not doing a great job keeping up with me. But you can see, I'm going to rename this layer. Save it. I'm going to rename this full spectrum color. Now, of course, I can also just paint with any color I want on this full spectrum layer. But using that gradient overlay is a really easy way to do it. And I can obviously play with all the different weird ways to introduce it. So if I use dissolve, then it will kind of color it in this textured way. And of course, I'm playing with different opacities. And if I don't like it in certain places, I don't like how brown that made the inside of the mouth, I can just use my eraser, soft-edged, and I can erase out the full spectrum in some places where I think it's less helpful. All right. Now, what's more, if I make another combined color layer here. The sandwich can be as complicated as we want. Select all of them, even though they're locked, right? Hold down Option, say Layer, Merge Layers. Now I have a combined color layer. This is my instep. Before we submit. Now on that combined color layer, I'm going to turn on my gray background, and I'm just going to play with my adjustments, just like with compositing. First with levels. Do I want to brighten it or darken it in the midtones? Do I want to limit my highlights or limit my shadows? Right. Next, I go to color balance on my combined color layer. And I start with the midtones. I'm going to push it a little bit more towards red, a little bit more towards yellow, just a touch. Maybe a little away from green. In my highlights, I'm going to push it more towards red, more towards yellow, a little bit towards green. And then in my shadows, I'm going to push it towards cyans and blues, maybe magentas. Okay. Subtle difference. Next, image adjustments. Hue saturation. This is for big movements. Just shift the hue. See what I like. And hopefully it is close to the middle, because that's what I spend a lot of time on. Maybe around there. And then how intense. And I like the intensity on everything but the yellow. So I'm going to bring the intensity up, and then I'm going to go just to yellow and bring that intensity down and brighten it. And maybe the reds, let's see. You can isolate colors this way in all the variations you've created. Bring up the blues, bring up the cyans. Darken colors. And now that's another tool you have, right? Once you're happy with your coloring, and actually I'm going to turn this to dissolve, and I'm going to turn it down, and that's going to give a little bit of texture to my color, which I like. See it? Beautiful. That subtle, subtle texture. Okay. Now, it's time to turn it in. So, to turn it in, I turn off my background, but I'm not done yet. There's one other thing we can do. If you want to color on top of your black line art, this is the last thing I want you to know. You do what are called color holds. So I use Wonder Woman because she has a golden lasso. And that lasso, you can't make a glowing lasso with black lines. So those black lines need to be replaced with color. This is an example of a color hold. This is an example of a color hold. That is an example of a color hold. This is an example of a color hold. Right? So, to finish it off, I can take my black line art, duplicate it, not even rasterize it, but make sure it's unlocked, change its color overlay to something else instead of black. Or I can change it to a gradient, and then I can play with its opacity. So if I wanted to give this like a real children's book kind of vibe, I might have this slight gradient on my black line art. And that's a color hold. That's kind of your finish. If you wanted to make like a little glint in the teeth or something. I've created a color hold here because I decided I didn't like the black rings, and so I just replaced them with orange. Let's see, let's make this multiply. Let's try that. All right, so once you're finished, you're going to say File, save for your PSD,